Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hi, I'm Tim Shepard. Just being in the outdoors is what I love about hunting. It's just some romantic part to it. It was kind of what I got earlier. Training is a whole side and separate thing. Once I started with, got my own bird dog, I decided I needed to train him. And what I enjoy about training is really just watching the dog work. Watching that dog flip a switch from what that dog was at home to become what it was bred to do out in the field. That's what I get my most enjoyment out of. When I'm hunting, that is more rewarding to me to watch that dog really work and enjoyment he's having doing it than even a harvesting game. I got my first hunting dog a little over 4 years ago. I've been hunting since I was 15, but I would hunt 1 to 2 days a year for many, many years. I finally decided maybe 6 years ago that I wanted to get back into hunting and pursue that a little bit more on a more regular basis. I started hunting with a friend who had a German Shorthair Pointer, and his friend who would come along from time to time had a Brittany. So we go out and hunt together, and I decided at that point, just watching the dog go on point from the first time I saw it, it was life-changing. I just knew, wow, that is so cool. I want to go get me one of those dogs, right? And so I researched dogs, and at the time I was living in a condo, and I researched all the breeds that I thought would do and perform well on the birds and the type of hunting that I did. And I settled on the Epineal Breton or the French Brittany. I didn't settle on it, actually I picked it. So my first dog was a male Epineal Breton, or Americans call them French Brittany. They're compact, they're the smallest of all the pointing breeds. They seem to fit well with the condo lifestyle that I was in. 3 years later, I purchased a home and decided at that point I wanted to get another dog to keep my buddy company during the day. And went back, and they say Epineal Bretons are like potato chips. You know, you can't just have one, so now I have two. The breed's history, from what I understand, or from what I've read, I can't tell you the dates. The origin is France. The Englishmen, the noblemen that would come over and hunt in France, they would bring their dogs, but England wouldn't let them bring them back. So they would come and hunt in France and then leave their dogs. And those dogs got together with the local dogs, which are kind of the foundation dog of this breed. You know, there's a story I heard that back in those times when this breed was established and carried on through France, it was a poacher's dog. It was a peasant's, it was a common man's dog. And they would take them to the edges of the nobleman's field and let them run, and they would run low and gather game and bring it back to them. I don't think I could say that it has a specialty skill set other than, especially for upland hunting, it can do it all. Has a great nose, has a great desire to hunt, has a lot of stamina, very athletic little dogs. Okay. What I've noticed with my dogs is, like I say, when you get them out in the field, they're definitely a flip of the switch. They love to hunt, and they have no problem hunting all day under the right conditions. The noses on these dogs are just fantastic. The style is a little different. The pointing style is a little different, like all pointing breeds. I particularly really like it. And they just seem to do everything that I want them to do. This breed is the foundation breed of what we know in America as the American Brittany. So the American Brittany came from these dogs. They were bred from these dogs. So what you'll notice in the French Brittany is they have more of a blockier size style head, whereas the American is a little slopier. The French Brittanies, actually, the acceptable colors for conformation are orange and white, liver and white, black and white, or a tricolor, which is a combination of all different colors. My older dog is an orange and white dog, okay, which is more of a what we consider a Brittany should look like, right? So when I was looking for my first Brittany, I was really looking for an orange and white dog because I thought that orange and white with a little more white would be better suited to the warmer temperatures here in Southern California, with some of the warmer temperatures that I hunt. I don't know if that's necessarily true. And after I had my dog for a little over, it was close to 3 years, I started looking for another one. And at that point, I started being drawn to the tricolors, which is the color that my youngest one is, which is, she's predominantly black. She has some orange and she has some white, and it's a little bit of a roan design, which is kind of a lot of colors all speckled through on the arms and so on. Those are all colors that are acceptable within the UKC and the Epinal Breton Breed Club. My oldest French Brittany is just a little over four. His name is Beau. The younger French Brittany, her name is Maisie, and she'll be two next month. I think maybe some of the things, what they do and the differences that they have is kind of a reflection on me. Beau was my first dog, and there was a lot of times, you know, I used to look down at him and say, hey, man, I'm sorry, you know. He's going to be limited by what I can show him or expose him to. He's really close to being finished. We've got to finish up some retrieving. Is really his stumbling block. Whereas Maisie, she seems to be more of a natural retriever, which is good, as what I was really looking for. But we've got a long way to go with her as well. My bucket list, I don't necessarily have one big hunt, one big destination that I'd really like to go and, you know, and hunt. Not at the moment. The last couple years I've been hunting a lot down in Mexico. I've been having the opportunity to do a lot of fantastic pheasant hunting and dove hunting and some duck and some quail hunting. So that's been fantastic. So I haven't been able to had to drive more than 4 hours to, you know, go out and shoot quite a bit of game and or fields where there is plentiful game. I wanted to do it this year, but I plan to do it next year. I heard the bird numbers were down, but I think my next trip out of state is going to be to Arizona, and we're going to go chase some Mearns quail. Hunting is a big part of my life. It's almost a sense of freedom. You know, it just fulfills me and energizes me. I enjoy it very much. I don't seem to hunt as hard as I used to. I used to do a lot of chucker hunting, which, if people know what chucker hunting is, it's pretty steep, but you get a pretty athletic type of hunting. I tend to prefer to do a little bit lower stuff, although I still do some chucker hunting. Honestly, I think I hope I can hunt as long as I can, you know, for many, many more years, right? Many more years. You know, starting hunting to me, when I first started hunting, that first exposure to it was all, I can't believe that I'm actually getting to do this, right? It just seemed like part of the American tradition. It's something we were almost of a right that we were born to do. And I hope it stays that way for a long time.